Hey, my babies.
Welcome to the channel.
Welcome back to the channel. Hey, you guys, and if you are new, hey, welcome to the channel. Go ahead, press the subscribe button. I'm gonna wait on you. Anyways, you guys, as you can see by the title of the video, we have a mukbang. This is some good old
homemade hot wings.
Homemade hot wings and homemade
barbecue wings. I made them.
Barbecue wings. The best, y'all. I mean, my mama got some good homemade hot wings too. So, we are about to eat these wings and discuss relationship problems. Not just any relationship problems, but some of our relationship problems. And the reason I wanted to do this video is because I want to do a video where we give out relationship advice. Because we have some really good advice for us, you know, keeping your relationship happy, keeping the funk in it. I mean, the spunk.
Spunk.
You know, we have some really good advice and really good tips. To, you know, help y'all out to, you know, make sure the relationship is going strong. But, you know what I'm saying, I ain't just want to come and be telling y'all these good tips and how to keep your relationship strong and stay happy. And everybody go through problems. We all go through problems. Like, you're going to go through problems no matter what. So, you know, a lot of people like to act like they don't go through problems. They want to come and tell everybody the good stuff, how to keep a relationship going and this, this, and that. But nobody ever talks about the problems. Nobody talk about, like, you know, the issues. So we're going to discuss relationship issues because, honestly, we want y'all point of view on some certain things. Dwayne don't even know what we're about to talk about. I didn't tell him exactly what we're going to talk about. But there's about two things that I'm going to bring up. And it's like we don't agree on these two things. So, maybe if y'all put y'all two cents in, you know, it'll help one of us clarify who is right. You know what I'm talking about?
No, you know? I got a few ideas.
But, okay, so, first things first. One of our relationship issues, well, everybody, I'm not going to say everybody, but a lot of people, you know, have trust issues. We about 2 years in, so I'm not gonna say we don't have trust issues, but it's not like probably like the average or the, I'm not gonna say average, it's probably not like just starting off. Well, no, because just starting off, you try to kind of trust the person all of them.
Yeah, I'm about to say, you know,
when you just starting off, the trust is actually high. It's what, it's like when you do something in a relationship that brings the trust down. So, far as like, okay, I'm gonna say this, far as like him being with another girl or stuff like that, like, I don't think that's not one of my trust issues come in at with him. Like, I actually don't have too many trust issues with you. I trust you. I just feel like you're sneaky sometimes. Mm-hmm. So, yeah. Like, I feel like, you know, tell me the full truth. Like, I don't feel like you cheating or you talking to other girls or stuff like that. I just feel like it's like little stuff that I feel like you just don't be telling me the truth about. But I don't feel like you're cheating.
That's how you started to become a mukbang.
I know. And then you started eating. Because I had to say something first. I should have wrote down what I had. What I had in my head earlier, because that's not it. Okay. Well, this is my, I'm going to start off by saying, this is good as hell.
Man,
So good. Okay. So, this is the one thing that Dwayne and I, We don't get into it over this, but once we are in a heated conversation, once I get mad, I tend to say things that I don't mean, I say mean hurtful things. You know, my mouth is just very reckless. And one of the things that I say when I'm mad is bitch. Like, I call him a bitch when I'm mad. And he, I feel like it's not a big deal. I feel like I called you a bitch, oh well, let it go, move on. Don't call me a bitch back though. Just let it go, keep on whatever, say what you gotta say, move on. He feels like a man is not supposed to be called a bitch, no matter what.
No real man. That's what I feel like, no real man. If, see, I come from places, I done been in places where respect is everything. And that word right there is a dangerous word. When you call another man that, you have no respect for him. And I'm not just saying it like, if like we just playing, laughing, giggling, you know, something like that. Oh, bitch ass nigga, you crazy. Oh, you stupid, something like that. But when you saying it to insult me, that's a different thing.
But that's the thing. Like, if I'm mad and I call you a bitch, it's because I'm mad. It ain't because I really feel like, oh, you a bitch ass nigga. It's just because I'm mad. And that's just what happens when I'm mad. But it don't mean that I mean it. And it's like, that's what I be wanting him to understand. I don't mean you a bitch. I'm just mad. Why can't you understand that I'm just mad? And that's why I'm saying this. And why can't you just let it go? But instead, when I call him a bitch, he gets mad. I'm talking about he gets madder. And then, you know, then he started disrespecting me. So then it's like, you know, it's the ongoing thing of disrespect. And, you know, it's like, I don't even know.
That's something hard to turn off when all you know, you a bitch, you go. I'm a bitch, you gotta show me now. You know what I'm saying? That's something hard just to turn off. Anytime you just hear somebody calling you a word in a heated conversation. And you already heated. You know, you can't just up and turn that off like that. Oh, she don't mean it like that. Oh, your mind ain't gonna drift it. Oh, she don't mean it like that. Until after you think about it or calm down or something like that.
You feel like it shouldn't be said, period. Like, you don't feel like, like what you just said, you don't be thinking about it like that. Like, you feel like it shouldn't be said, period.
Because where I come from, once again, people say what they mean when they angry. You know, so when we first have arguments and you showed me that, I really felt like you meant a lot of that, because same way a drunk man tell no lie, an angry person tell no lie.
That's bullshit, babe. I tell buku lies when I'm mad. Actually, that's when I tell the most lies. When I'm mad, I say a whole lot of shit to piss you off and to get under your skin, but I don't be meaning it. Like, it be a lie, so that's not true. Just because a person mad doesn't mean they're going to speak the truth. No. Some people mad, and they're going to say whatever they got to say to get you mad. Like, and that's just...
A lot of people waiting for mad day to tell the truth or to rat on somebody, whether it's kids or adults. You know, that's something mainly on, like, petty shit, but still.
Huh?
When I mean like petty shit, it'd be like friends getting into it. Oh, you did this, I'm going to tell on you did this. Woo-doo, I'm going to tell you did this. Exposing each other. Oh, I never liked it, you woo-doo. It wants to calm down. I didn't mean it. I loved you. Woo-doo.
Yeah, but everybody do not do that because they mad. Okay, well, for starters, I'm going to say, I know that it is not right to call him nor anyone else a bitch. Just because I'm mad, I know that's not right. And I really am working on it. He says I'm not working on it, but I really am working on it. And I know it's a disrespectful word. I know, you know, if you're in a heated conversation, it shouldn't come up. Like, I know that. But my whole thing is, you know I know this. You know this is just, I'm not gonna say it's just me, but this is how I react. So it's like, you know, don't disrespect me back. Just, you know, help me work on it. You know? The disrespectful back. Because two wrongs ain't going to make a right. So it's like, I guess I be looking for him to not get back mad with me. But when he get mad, it's like no cutting him off. He go from 0 to 100 real quick, and then he gonna say everything he gotta say. Even when you done, he gonna still be talking. But the good thing about him is he don't hold grudges. Like, once he got it off his chest and he done talking, you know, he done, he could go right back to being good and being like we never got into it. Me, on the other hand, I hold grudges. Like, I always been like that. Like, I don't know. That's something I'm working on too. Because
I'm not the type
I don't want to hold grudges.
I'm not the type of person to dwell. If I dwell on something, that means it was really tragic.
What's something I do that you don't like, babe? Oh, what's something you do that you think I don't like? Or, like, what's another problem you have that we need to work on?
She hate my impulsiveness. Like, once I click and I get mad, I don't care where I'm at. You know, we can be in the store, in traffic, whatever. I'm going to flash, I'm going to click, I'm going to say what I got to say. I don't care who around. She hates that with a passion.
I hate it with a passion. Because I feel like he letting everybody in and on our business. That's not everybody's business. Like, whatever we got going on, whatever you mad about, whatever, it ain't everybody's business. So for you to just flash out, get crazy, that it's not everybody's business. Sometimes we'll be around people. Sometimes it's just us. It's just the principle. It's a way you could duck yourself. You could get your point across without flashing out, getting loud and crazy. Because guess what? When you get loud and crazy, it's only a matter of time before the next person get loud and crazy. You know, it's only a matter of time. So
I be feeling like she be doing the stuff she does on purpose because she know that it's gonna get me out of my character, calling me the B word, or talking crazy.
Okay, that's another thing though. Like, okay, let's go with that.
If you know this is gonna get me out of my character, why even go that route if you don't want to see me take that route?
Cause I be mad and I be wanting you to be mad. Like, I be wanting him to feel how I feel.
So if you can't take my feelings into consideration on how I feel, why should I take your feelings into consideration on how you feel when I react the way I react?
Because first of all, I do take his feelings into consideration. Like, babe. Yes, I do.
I'm saying you don't. I'm saying when you get mad, you see what I'm saying? And you just forget about it. Fuck this shit.
Well, of course. When I get mad, yeah. I mean,
you see, and but once I get mad, I'm the same way. So why make me mad?
Don't make me mad. I won't make you mad.
Two wrongs don't make it right.
I'm so contradicted. Y'all, I'm a Gemini, by the way. So, like, you know, I really do believe in it. Like, I really do believe I have two different personalities. Shout out to the Geminis. If you're a Gemini, go ahead and give this video a big thumbs up right now. Drop down in the comments, pound team Gemini, okay? Gemini rules the world, okay? So anyways, I feel like, you know, what?
Man.
I feel like sometimes I could be like, double-sided, I could be contradicting, I could be this, I could be that, but I feel like my level of understanding is so high, that if you come and talk to me about something, like, we could totally work it out.
Let's bring the fat ass hand, y'all.
But he's full, y'all. And we're drinking on some wine right here.
I'm not a whiner.
But,
pretty good.
But I feel like, you know, if we was to talk about stuff first, because that's another thing with him. Like, he don't talk. He just be just hot-headed from the jump. Hot-headed from the jump. So it'd be so hard to talk because he hot-headed from the jump. It's like, seriously, y'all, when I say 0 to 100 real quick, 0 to 100 real quick.
I hate to argue.
So it'd be hard to talk to him. Because he don't want to talk. He want to just yell.
I hate to argue.
You hate to argue.
I got bad nerves. So basically, she's saying you got to have some understanding amongst each other. If you want to work it out, it's going to be things that y'all don't like about each other. Hate each other with a passion. And you're going to be like, oh, I can't be with this person because of that reason. But that's just one reason. You see what I'm saying? So if this person is willing to work on that reason, oh, I give up.
Right. Got to be willing. All that is for the good advice, babe. We got to stay on the bad stuff. Anyways, you guys. Basically, we made this video because there is no such thing as a perfect relationship. There's no such thing as a perfect relationship. I do believe two people could be perfect for each other, but having a perfect relationship is just never gonna happen. Like, I don't care how long you've been with a person, y'all still gonna have some type of problems at some point of time. Something is gonna occur. I mean, it might not be a big problem. It might be something so tiny, something so small. When I say a problem, I don't necessarily mean like, oh, somebody's gonna get cheated on or, you know, like the most. It could be the littlest things, because our problems, like the stuff that we argue about, the stuff that we get into it about, I promise y'all, it's the littlest things. It's not like about him cheating or about me cheating, or it's not the fact that, oh, you stay gone to 3 o'clock in the morning. Like, it's none of that type of stuff. It really be like little stuff, y'all. And it just blows up because, I guess, I don't know, we both so passionate for one another. I believe that that's why our arguments get so bad, because, you know, we really do love one another and we really do want to be with each other and we really do try to prove that to each other. And it's annoying and frustrating when the other person don't see it or not getting it, or, you know, may feel like the opposite. But at the end of the day, we love each other. And, you know, we gonna go through problems. We have problems. Anyways, y'all, we finna wrap this video up. We will be back tomorrow. Well, actually, you guys, I decided that I want to upload on Mondays, Wednesdays. Wait. No, it was Sundays, Mondays, Wednesdays, and possibly Fridays. If I upload in between those days, that's just a bonus, you know what I'm saying? Y'all just count your blessings, okay? Yep. But those 4 days for sure, 3 to 4 days for sure, I am definitely going to upload for you guys. So if you guys don't see me tomorrow, you will see me again on Wednesday. And Wednesday, why am I holding this little piece of meat in my hand? Okay. So Wednesday, you guys, we will be back. And on Wednesday, on that video, we're going to give you guys some advice and some tips and some things that we do to keep our relationship strong and to keep it going. Because, you know, like I said, we have problems, but like, I'm happy. Like, what I'm saying is, yeah, we go through problems, we go through shit, like we really do. And our fights get big sometimes. But at the end of the day, like, this man really makes me happy. Like, without him and my kids, like, I don't know. Like, I don't even know. Because they really make me happy. Like, I'm happy. Like, I'm so happy. I don't go out, y'all. I don't do nothing. I am, like, such a lame-o. Like, all I do is go to work and come home because I just be wanting to be up under my man. Like, for real. Like, I don't be wanting to go out. I don't be going hanging out at my girls' houses. You know, like, every now and then, you know, because it's not healthy to be with your partner, like, to be up under your partner that much. I don't know. They say it's not healthy, but I mean, we be up under each other a lot, and we good. I mean, I wouldn't say this. I don't know who said that shit not healthy, but anyways,
we do a lot together.
Yeah, we do everything together, like everything. So you know what I'm saying? At the end of the day, we have our problems. We go through shit. But we are happy with each other. We love each other.
Everybody know I'm in love with you, girl. Yeah. They know I'm happy. She makes me happy. She makes me smile. She makes me want to do better. I did stuff that I never thought I'd do, you know, since I got with her. You know what I'm saying? She made me believe in shit that I never believed in, you know?
Oh.
And I'm good where I'm at. So I don't be trying to, I'm not trying to move nowhere, move around, mess with none of that. So baby, all I do.
Everybody don't understand yo.
My lingo?
Yeah, you be talking to, you gotta talk. Like, don't understand slang, all that slang.
Basically, I'm not trying to go nowhere. I'm not in no one's inbox. You know, I go to work, I come home, I'm chilling. You know, when she doing her thing, stuff like that.
I play my videos
or her makeup, her wig, stuff like that. And, you know, well, I'm chilling by myself, you know, I hop on my game, do that. Once she's done with that, I'm done with the game. She got my undivided attention, you know, so I'm not on the game, nothing like that. So I'm good where I'm at, you know what I'm saying? I love the way she makes me feel, you know. I love you too baby, I'm not trying to let that change, I'm not trying to change that, don't want it to change, nope, forever is our thing.
We're gonna ride this shit till we can't run them on. Y'all know I'm a rapper, you know what I'm saying? I mean, I'm not lying. But anyways, you guys, thank you guys so much for watching this video. If you like this video, please give it a big thumbs up. Don't forget to drop some comments down below. Share the video. If you are not subscribed, like, what are you doing? Why you not subscribed yet? Go ahead and subscribe to your girl.
Subscribe or die.
Subscribe or die.
Make that call. No people.
Anyways, you guys, thank you guys so much for watching. I love you guys so much. And you guys, in the future, I am going to work on uploading a lot earlier because I know it's going to be a little late. So I'm going to work on uploading at least between 6 and 7. I know it's going to be after 6 or 7 when this video is uploaded. Hopefully not too much later, but I know it's going to be a little later because I think it's already like 5 something or something like that. I don't know. But anyways, you guys, thank you guys so much. I love you guys so much, and I will see you in the next video.
Peace.
We need barbecue and eat this. Slap.
I thought you were saying it in a bad way. What the fuck is slap?
I knew you was gonna say that. These love good, bro.